Well, praise the Lord, saints. To God be the glory for this time that we get to be together. The Lord woke me up around 3:30 this morning to deliver a word to his people. And so before I get into this word, know that I encourage you to pray over it, pray about it, receive, test the spirits. And also know that whenever a word is given, it's not a time of what we extrapolate to think and want to interpret. I'm not into any of that. I'm only here to give you the word so you can take it before the Lord, pray about it, and then follow how he would lead and guide you. Okay, so just want to always make that clear. I don't need to give you commentary. It's God does a good enough job speaking what he needs to speak. So here is the word from the Lord at 3:35 a.m. on January 30th, 2019. The world collapses around the corner. Do not fear if you know me, for I am your God who loves you. Now is the time to truly turn your hearts to me. Many have, yet many more of you are still playing church while mourning the dead who in their glory mock all things of me. Do not think I do not see. I am God, am I not? It is now that my true church arise. I have said before, and I will say again, my church is rising in the east. Do not believe the false reports that I am dead in the east. No, it is in the west that continues to reject, deny, and mock me, my holiness, and my power. Yet rest assured, the entire world will surely know I am God, and my son is the one who is to come. There is no escape from truth, and the truth is that for those who know me, your best is upon you. For those who still choose to laugh and deny, all your fears will be at your doorstep sooner than you think. The miracles you have talked about yet not experienced or witnessed, get prepared for. They will abound in my true people. Be on watch, for the miracles in the children of the devil are abound as well. Yet pay not attention and be deceived not. They are mere distractions and mockeries to my power. To see my fullness operate, you must reject sin and all its partners, for you can no longer pretend you are mine, as your heartless hearts and worthless deeds will have no entrance value entering into what is to come. You must reject your carnal, worldly ways of life and turn fully to me, for there is where life is and will be. For those who deny, death's door is waiting for you. Be expecting should you mock and deny. I have been gracious, merciful, and patient for far too long. I have witnessed intense persecution worldwide against my children, and I will have no more of it. I have heard and seen enough, and this is a warning to turn your hearts to me while I am still found by you, or your depravity and captivity will be your resting place. The turmoil upon the earth isn't coming. It's already on the earth. You just have yet to open your eyes. Do not be so misled to think only the evildoers have all the power. Am I not God? Do I not see and know all? Do I not know the agendas of the wicked one and his agents? Do not fear, my children, for I am here. You just must listen and follow the words of my true prophets, for your safety and very lives depend upon it. There will be devastation the earth has never experienced and that mankind has not yet seen. It is marking my judgment for crimes against my word and me that have not yet been repented of. While many push their own judgment agendas of their liking, let it also be known judgment comes to them for their false ideas, not of me. Do not be so easily misguided. Do not be. Instead, turn all of you so you can hear me when I speak. Deny all that is not of me and enter into my presence. It does not matter wars or rumors of wars. Am I not God? Do I not always provide an escape route for my children? My escape for you isn't about rushing for more to think about in this carnal world. No, my escape and only escape is in Christ. Pray, my children. Pray for the east and the rising up of my children. Pray for the west and the fall soon upon it for its blasphemous living. Pray earnestly for one another, my children. Stand and stand. Do not falter, for I am with you. I am bringing forth all of what the world is yet to see. I am bringing what you have so longed for, desired for, because you are mine. To you, I say rejoice, for I am the living God. To those who still mock and deny in your hearts, you soon will see and know the foolishness of your ways. For all the days of your miserable existence, your ways will not redeem you beyond the miserableness you have chosen. You will not escape my wrath. You simply will not. You will be the mockery of your own while they vomit you out like the wretched, worthless one you are. Repent so you do not become the delight of the vultures. Your boasting, lies, and pride will no longer suffice. So repent and seek me while you can. My children, while many are speaking such much fear in my name, reject it. It is not my fear or wisdom. Rest in me, and there, and only there, is where you will find peace. You do not need to plot, plan, or date set among the heathens who do such things. No. Come to me, rest in me, and let me reveal my glory to you. Allow me to show you what you have yet to see. Then you will have all that you need for what is to come in my name. What is to come for you is not the same as it is for the world. So do not engage, but instead seek me. Look up, rejoice, for there I am, my children, your God, your Father, your everlasting love. Rejoice in me, my children. That is a word from the Lord on January 30th, 2020 at 3:55 a.m. God bless you, saints. Take that to the Lord. Pray about it. And that's all I have for today. God bless you.